All right, folks, it is time to head to Hawaii's Kitchen. Maize Hawaii is teaching us how to make three different dishes today. All are perfect for the 4th of July weekend. We are here at Ferguson Showroom. We've got Executive Chef Ryan Day to my left.
Hi, good
Hello.
Morning.
And we've got Ross Yamaguchi
good
to
morning.
My right. Ross, you are making a dish for our first segment, and I am super excited. This looks like a great dish to take to our 4th of July barbecue coming up on Saturday. What's the name of this dish?
Well, I call it Maize Kalua Pork Nacho Cups.
So Maize Kalua Pork Nacho Cups.
Nacho, regular nachos.
Nacho, regular
nachos. Yeah, just play on words.
I love it. It's brilliant. Now, how did you guys decide to try it in a cup?
Well, I have kids, and we went to a party, and they just laid the nachos out, cut in little triangles and things like that, put the kalua on it, and put lomi on it. And the kids were picking it up, sticking their hand in the pan. It was falling on the side. It was all over the place. So we thought, why don't we try to put it in cups? That way they can grab their own, put it on a plate, and go off.
Brilliant.
Spill
I love
it. Somewhere
it.
Else.
All right, so what's the first step?
Okay, the first step is we take a kalua pork.
Okay.
And basically, we just heat it up. And you can go ahead. It's already fully cooked. And you can cook it to your texture. You can make it really hard.
I say this every time I'm with you guys, but uh-huh. I love that these are pre-cooked.
Yes, they are.
Yep. You know, so you've got the kalua pork brand already cooked. You can just heat it up.
Correct. You can either it in a pan, microwave it, throw it in the oven. So basically what we do is we get this started.
Okay.
And when we get this...
I can do that for you. While this is cooking, through the magic of television, we actually have it cooked there.
And so what I do next here is we take your simple one-ton... And we just put a little oil... So that what we do is we have the oven preheat at 350. Okay. And we just put a little oil for it to brown and everything. So this is the tricky part.
Okay.
Because it's in a mini muffin pan.
Okay.
So from doing this, I take two fingers and I just put it, shove it down.
Okay, I want to try that.
Okay.
Can I pass this on to you?
The oil keeps it flexible and keeps it from drying out.
Correct. Okay. And it also gets that golden brown color. You want me to oil it up for you?
I have always wanted to do this. No, I want to do it by myself.
It's oily.
I'm like a three-year-old.
So all your potlucks, your graduation parties, poo-poos, and say tailgating.
More. You can get
do
it
the
on
edges
the corners. Yeah.
The corners.
So when you push it down, it basically comes into a cup, and it's... It looks kind of pretty with a little flower and edges. That's good, yeah.
Okay, so two fingers.
Yep, and you can just put it down.
Hey now.
Wow.
Yay!
You're hired.
Yeah, that's great.
It's a little lopsided.
You want another one?
Yes. This is fun. Okay, so you said 350 degrees for how long?
We put it in for 5 to 7 minutes.
That's all?
That's it.
Okay.
The wonton is really thin, so... It cooks really well. And it instead of deep frying it, we're throwing it in the oven.
Okay. All right. So through the magic of television, you also
before we do
add
that,
salt.
I sprinkle some salt just to get some flavor on the wonton.
Okay.
And then we stick it in the oven.
All right. So let's put that in there.
And why not? Put it on. Oh, it's hot, right?
Through TV magic,
folks watching at home, use pot holders.
Yeah.
Okay, you want to push that in? Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Nice.
So, we put the kalua pig in.
Yes, we do. So what we do from here, it's fairly simple. We just grab the kalua. I use chopsticks. Okay. It's easier to just get it in there.
All right. We're almost out of time. Do we have another chopsticks? I can help you.
Actually, I'll show you some. It's the finished product. So what we do is we grab it and we grab.
It's just the lomi lomi salmon.
It's the lomi.
I'm sorry. You drained it, right?
Yes, it's drained lomi. You want to try it too?
Yeah. I promise you, I'm going to make this.
She's
going
to make it, so,
so
she's
excited.
Practicing for the house. Yeah.
I think this looks so cool. It'll never leave here full.
We're eating that.
All right.
Oh, you really like lomi, huh?
I do.
I like kalua.
Kalua pig. I like kalua pig and lomi. Okay, so this is really fun. So you just fill this in.
Correct.
but not so messy, right?
Yeah.
And then you put the lomi salmon.
Correct. Right on top.
Okay. And then what do you have in your hands?
And we have, I made a little mixture of mayonnaise and a little, you can use any seasoning that you want, or you can just use straight mayonnaise.
Okay.
So I put this thing called Beaumondo.
Beaumond.
Beaumond, that my mother used to make these other kind of Christmas treats before, so.
Okay, and you just put
salty,
that right on
and
the
I
top?
Just give it a little squeeze and.
See? Like little
Yay.
Cupcakes.
Yeah, and look at the finished product.
That's
this
it.
Is
Bam.
Such an impress your friends type of dish, poo-poo dish. No one would ever believe that I made that, but I'm going to.
And Yay. You know the best part is eating it, because you can just pick it up.
That's right.
And pop it right in your mouth. Oh, if it doesn't break on it. Just pop.
Okay, do we want to do it now? I'm going to
sure.
go for the ones you guys
You made. Should always taste it before you serve it, so. Crunchy, salty, smoky, yum.
How is it?
Excellent. Back to you guys.
It's really bad. You don't want to eat it. There you go.
So talk about it. You tried it.
I have to tell you that I truly always love the dishes we make from maize.
Oh, it's all good.
But that is one of my favorites.
It might be the top of the list, huh?
It was so delicious, and I love how they're in these little cups.
Yeah, beautiful.
So I am going to make it this weekend.
And like you said, for a party, it looks beautiful, but man, that crunch when you bit into it.
Oh, it tasted just so good. And you know, the warm Kahlua pig with the cold, I mean, just
the savory,
the flavors, the crunchy. Excellent. I could not stop eating that.
And we were watching in the beginning, literally, you just open up the packet, put it in there, just break it up.
So easy.
So easy and so
fast. So we're going to have the recipe on our website.
Yep. And then you got a couple more dishes coming up a little bit later, right?
Two more dishes.
Love
those. When maize comes, I mean.
They bring it.
It's a feast for everyone working.
Yep.
Yes.